Welcome friends, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Creating an app is very easy, but writing a structured code that is maintainable for the long term and is also testable is not that easy. To write a code that is maintainable, understandable and testable, we follow design patterns. So here I am with a new course to teach you all how to follow the most popular design pattern that is used to develop Android applications. And yes, I am talking about the MVVM or Model View View Model design pattern. This pattern is also recommended and loved by Google. Before moving on to MVVM, let's first discuss something about design patterns in general. Like, why do we even need a design pattern? We were developing the apps and it was working well. Now, what is the need to make things more complicated? But when we talk about an app, most of the times it is a product. So assume this scenario. You was working on an app in a company. It was working well, but after some time you left the company and a different person came to work on the same application. This person now will face a lot of difficulty to understand what the hell you have written. Reading a badly written code by someone else is nothing less than a nightmare. But if we follow proper guidelines, design patterns, and the best practices to write code, it is easy to understand for anyone. So the number one point of using design pattern is it makes our code more understandable. If the code is understandable, then it is easy for any developer to start working on it. And even for you, if you are the original author of the code. And you know this thing very well. If you touch your project that you written like 3-4 months before, then you yourself face difficulties understanding it. So following a proper design pattern makes our project maintainable for a long run. You know, as a beginner, how we create apps while learning. We put everything in our activity or fragment classes, like a network call and all the other heavy things. Everything we put inside the activity or fragment classes. And you know, this is the worst practice of writing code. This makes our codes tightly coupled. That means more dependent on each other. And if you are from a computer science background, you may have learned that tightly coupled software codes are very, very bad. But when we follow a design pattern, we take care of coupling. And it makes our project loosely coupled. And if our project is loosely coupled, it is easy to test. So following a good design pattern makes our project testable as well. And if our project have all these things that we just discussed, it is easy for us to make changes on the existing project and add new features. I guess now you understand very well that why using a design pattern is necessary for building a good application. Google suggests some common architectural principles that almost all the design patterns follow. The first thing is separation of concern. As we discussed, we write all the codes in activity or fragment. This is the most common mistake. Our activity or fragment should contain the logics that are responsible for UI related things only. One of the common problems you might have already faced when we use retrofit in our fragment and try to update the UI by fetching some data, our application crashes. The problem is we don't own the fragment or the activity, and the Android system can destroy it anytime because of the Android system needs. For example, in case of low memory. So if we are trying to update a fragment that is already destroyed, it leads to the crash. So we should make these UI classes independent from our network calls. And doing this, we can avoid the lifecycle related problems. The next principle is we should derive the UI data from a model. Model is the component that is responsible for handling data of the application. And it is independent from the views. And because it is independent from the views, it is unaffected by the lifecycle problems. Now the main question is why you should use MVVM. we have the other design patterns as well, like MVC, MVP, then YMVVM. The selection of a pattern completely depends on your need. There are no perfect pattern exist that solves all the problem. Every pattern has their own advantages and disadvantages, and according to the problem they are chosen. Google recommends using MVVM. Actually, the term MVVM is never openly said by Google, but the pattern it is recommending is popular as MVVM in the developer community. Google says we should use it, but it also says that if we have some other pattern that is following the common architectural principles, then you can keep using it. So you can say MVVM is just a random selection to create this course, because all the viewers were requesting about MVVM, and Google also recommends it. This diagram explains the MVVM architecture. First, we have the activity or fragment classes, and it is basically the UI of our application. To display data, we use the data binding with the help of ViewModel. So our activity is just dependent on ViewModel to get the data. Now the benefit is ViewModel will not update the data if the view is destroyed. So the problem of lifecycle changes is solved. ViewModel will fetch the data from the repository. So again, ViewModel is just dependent on the repository to get the data. The repository may use the local database, that is SQLite, or our backend server using RESTful APIs. So only repository is dependent on multiple data sources to get the data. In this approach, we use local first. That means we will try to fetch the data from local storage first, because if the user has a connectivity issue, application will still work. Because using RESTful API for the data requires network connection to be available. As you can see, the architecture is separating everything. But while coding, you may end up thinking that, hey, why I cannot directly get the data from SQLite instead of following this ViewModel and repository chain? But trust me, it is very important. So keep in mind that you always follow this rule and never skip anything. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you are excited about this course. So let me know your excitement by commenting below. And in case you want to connect with me, you can go to my Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Please share this video with your friends who are learning Android development. And I will see you in the next video where we will start the actual Android project. So thanks for watching, guys. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.